the same old, same old. Yeah? Today or later?
Later.
Okay. Yeah, it's actually made from scratch. So if you never had it, it's like hot cinnamon sunset tea brewed with honey, vanilla, and milk. So yeah, it's not made from a powder or anything like that, but it's really good.
Well, one of the things that I love most about coffee is how fleeting a really good cup of coffee can be. Like, coffee doesn't happen by accident. Like, really good coffee, exceptional coffee, doesn't happen by accident. So everything from, you know, the seed, the planting, seedling, soil, climate, elevation, and then the processing, whether it's wet or dry, all of those things are going to impact the ultimate end cup. And then we finally get it here in the U.S. And so out of the hundreds and hundreds of offerings that any given importer may have, I'm only looking at maybe 10 of those that meet the standards that I have towards coffee. I started roasting when I was about 15 or 16 years old, and that was a guy coming into one of the coffee shops that I worked at, and he said that he just roasted coffee and we would sell him green coffee. And he roasted in a popcorn popper just at the house. And so at that time, I never knew somebody could just roast at home, and home roasting was something really new to me. And so I took some green coffee home, and then I started, I didn't want to use a popcorn right away, so I tried it in the oven first. And so my first time roasting, I put coffee into the oven and it filled the whole house with smoke, and my parents weren't home, and so I had smoke everywhere and I didn't know what to do with the coffee. And just at that moment that came in, the whole house was flooded with smoke, and so they asked me to take it outside. And so that's when I got a popcorn popper and I started roasting in there. And then the craft and the art and the science behind coffee just like really took a grab, a hold of me you know, how I could craft this into a perfection and get, you know, the perfect cup out of the coffee. And so that kind of started me on that journey. Once we get it in, part of the art and craft of roasting is a whole nother thing of where we influence what flavors we want to pull out of the coffee. But all at the same time, we're still just preserving the quality that's already within the coffee, and we can harm it by either misroasting it, under-roasting it, over-roasting it, stalling within the roaster. So there's a whole lot of things happening within the roaster that influence the end cup. So one of my philosophies in roasting is that I want to unleash and expose, you know, primarily a lot of sweetness in the coffee and any origin characteristics that it has to offer. So like, say if it was from Harar, I'm looking for a lot of blueberry and I want to expose that blueberry coming out of the coffee. So in different origins, different varietals will have different attributes. And so one of the things that sets me apart is that I want to expose those characteristics without introducing roast tones. So primarily what people are used to is over-roasted coffee, basically. And there's only a couple reasons why roasters would take coffee that dark. So with specialty coffee, when you have a quality coffee that doesn't have any flavor defects, you want to expose all of the beneficial attributes of the coffee. And I don't want to introduce roast tones, so people are able to taste just that really sweet cup that doesn't have that burnt, ashy flavor to it. So one of the things that I try to do is consistently educate people, and basically I'm trying to change their perception towards quality. So for a long time, people have kind of a conception towards coffee, you know, that it needs to be over roasted, that it needs to, you know, I still meet a lot of people who think that coffee should have this sheen of oil over it, and that's how you can tell that a coffee is good. But in reality, typically that means that the coffee is over roasted and or old and stale. So one of the best ways, obviously, to do is just have people taste the coffee and kind of describe the differences towards that. And I don't think I've ever met somebody who have tasted properly roasted specialty coffee and preferred something over roasted and bitter and things of that nature. And so it's trying to cultivate a knowledge and a passion towards what we're doing in the specialty coffee culture. So, and then that's done primarily through taste, and then also describing the differences of what we do and why what we do is better. But ultimately, taste is how we're accomplishing that.
This year, they're made in Italy. And then my roaster is from Israel. When I bought this, there's a couple US that I would buy now.
At the time,
yeah, they weren't around. Yeah.
Okay.
Do you like straws?
Yeah.